One of the fundamental decisions that a business owner must make is what type of entity should operate the business. There are four basic types of entities that we're going to talk about: sole proprietorship, partnership, corporation, and then limited liability company, or LLC. Let's talk about the pros and cons of each one of these. So the sole proprietorship, its biggest pro is the fact that it is simple. Okay? Simple to organize, simple to operate. There's only one owner, so you have nobody to fight with except for yourself. And that makes it a very attractive form of business for a lot of small businesses. Now, there's one huge con involving the sole proprietorship, and that is unlimited liability. Let's talk about that for a second. If the business were to get sued, as an example, and the lawsuit was successful for the plaintiff, and there were a judgment against the business, what could happen here is that the assets of the owner, the sole proprietor, could also be attached as part of that judgment. So you, as the business owner, stand to lose all of your personal assets on top of the business assets. So because the sole proprietorship really commingles personal and business activities, at least from an economic sense, if you operate a business as a sole proprietorship, you run the risk that your personal assets could be jeopardized if there is a situation where a creditor created a liability. So even though it's simple to operate, simple to form, a lot of businesses are looking for something more robust, and that's where we'll take a look at the partnership next. So one of the things about a partnership is that the disadvantage of a sole proprietorship, this unlimited liability, still exists with the partnership. And let's explore why that's the case. A partnership is essentially the sole proprietorship with multiple owners. So absent any mechanism for limiting liability, the partnership doesn't really do anything to improve on the sole proprietorship. You can almost think about it as being a sole proprietor with multiple owners. My first partnership was when I was age 6 or 7. The city of Grand Rapids was doing some road construction on my street where I lived, and the neighbor girl and I made a Kool-Aid stand. Now, we did not have a partnership agreement. We didn't even know that we had formed a partnership, but we had, okay? And the reality is we still had unlimited liability. If we had injured or made sick or killed one of those construction workers with some kind of tainted Kool-Aid, our parents probably would have had unlimited liability. There are flavors of a partnership that can limit liability for some of the partners. For example, there's something called an LLP, a limited liability partnership, that may accomplish some of that. But in its most basic form, the partnership still has the disadvantage of unlimited liability. Now, I'll still continue to say that a partnership is relatively flexible, especially when compared with the corporate form that we're going to take a look at in a few minutes. So we've got flexibility on our side. Now, the problem with flexibility is that unfortunately, we are going to need a partnership agreement if we want to run this properly, and that partnership agreement should give us some information about how we're going to measure profits. Will we be using U.S. GAAP, federal tax rules, whatever that might be? It'll also give us the rules for how we distribute profits or surplus of the partnership. So it's a little bit more cumbersome than the sole proprietorship, just because when you involve multiple people, there's going to be some complexity. There's going to be the need for additional rules and guidelines. But at its core, the partnership is pretty flexible compared to the corporation, but we retain this disadvantage of unlimited liability. So we know that if you're going to have multiple owners of a business, one of the disadvantages of the partnership is that there's unlimited liability. That's where the concept of a corporation comes into play. A corporation is a separate legal entity in the eyes of whatever state it's organized. corporation formation is governed by whatever state the corporation is organized in. And what we have here is, like I said, a separate legal entity. So a corporation can do a lot of the things that any individual can do. Just like you and I are different entities, a corporation is a separate entity. It can buy things, it can borrow money, it can sue, it can be sued, it can run a business. A corporation can't really go to jail, but if it does naughty enough things, the owners can certainly go to jail. So this corporation is a separate legal entity. Now, the big advantage is limited liability. Generally speaking, an investor's liability will be limited to their investment in the corporation. So in other words, if you invest $10,000 to purchase some shares of stock in a corporation, and the corporation goes bankrupt because of a major lawsuit, chances are you'll lose the $10,000, but you would not be on the hook for any other liabilities associated with that litigation. Now, we have to be careful not to delve into legal advice here, because there certainly are situations where we can pierce the corporate veil. If the corporation is not being run like a true corporation, for example, if it's not having regular meetings of the board of directors, if it's not filing resolutions, if it's not behaving in a corporate-like manner, a good prosecutor could probably unravel that corporation, or at least make a good effort to try to do that, and basically get rid of the corporate protection. But keep in mind that the intent of the corporation is to limit the liability of the shareholders. There are some other wonderful advantages to the corporate form of entity as well. It's relatively easy to transfer ownership. If I own some shares in a company and you want to then own those shares, I most likely can sell those to you if we come up with an arm's length deal. It's also fairly easy to raise large amounts of capital, especially if the corporation becomes a publicly traded company where we can tap into many, many, many investors. Now, there are a couple of disadvantages. One of the things that I think is a disadvantage is simply the hassle factor of running a corporation. You've got to run it like a corporation if you want that legal protection. So you have to have meetings of the board of directors, and you have to document those meetings in board minutes, and you have to make corporate resolutions. So we lose some of the flexibility of a partnership, but we get this wonderful liability protection. Now, the other thing to think about is if the corporation is taxed as what's called a C corporation, we can get exposed to something called double taxation. And the concept is this. Dividends that a corporation pays to its shareholders are not deductible for purposes of federal income taxes for a C corporation. That's just a type of taxation that a corporation would elect. So we have dividends getting paid to the owners, not deductible to the corporation. However, those dividends are most likely going to be included in the taxable income of the recipient. Hence the double taxation. We have a payment going from the corporation. So dividends are going from the corporation to the shareholders, not deductible for the corporation, but taxable to the shareholders. And guess what? If this shareholder happens to be another C corporation, we could even flirt with something called triple taxation. Now, there are strategies for alleviating this problem of double taxation. An S corporation election is certainly one of those strategies that we would explore, but you should understand that absent something like an S corporation election, one of the major disadvantages of the corporate form of entity is this concept of double taxation. So we've talked about sole proprietorships, partnerships, and corporations. And we know that corporations have this wonderful limited liability aspect that is so desirable because as a corporate owner, and especially consider this, as a corporation becomes bigger, the governance is different sometimes than the ownership and the management. We might have a board of directors that is governing overall and then managers running the corporation, but then the shareholders owning the corporation. So the shareholders elect the board of directors and the board of directors appoint managers to operate the corporation. So this limited liability in a corporate form really makes a lot of sense for large companies, but plenty of closely held businesses, maybe family businesses, especially those that are not publicly traded, they may want to have the limited liability of a corporation, which is the, you know, one of the major advantages, but they may also want the flexibility of a partnership. Okay? And I really don't think I have any cons to add to the list for limited liability companies, because a long time ago, somebody told me that the TV show Hannah Montana, I've never watched it, but they said she had the best of both worlds. Apparently, that's what the theme song says. I think she was a regular girl, and she also had a rock star life or something like that. That's what a limited liability company offers. It offers the best of both worlds. We get the flexibility of operating a partnership with the limited liability of a corporation. At this point, all of the states allow limited liability companies. And then what you can do is you can organize that entity. Now, the owners in a limited liability company are called members. So unlike a corporation where we have stockholders or shareholders, we have members of a limited liability company. And for taxation purposes, there's a lot of flexibility there too. If there's one member, then the limited liability company gets taxed like a sole proprietorship. In essence, just on Form 1040. One time when I was in public practice, I had a client that owned three radio stations, and it was a single member limited liability company. All of the business activity for tax purposes was recorded on Schedule C of his Form 1040 because it was a single member LLC. Now, another thing that can happen is the limited liability company could simply choose to have a default partnership taxation, or the LLC could elect to be a C corporation. It could even take a step further. Remember that double taxation that is a problem with C corporations. A limited liability company can even elect to become an S corporation. So not only is there flexibility for just running the entity and forming the entity, but even when we get to taxation, there's this whole menu of options that company owners can choose to be taxed as a sole proprietorship, a partnership, corporation, S corporation. It really is the best of both worlds.